Hello everyone, and I had the idea today of what would happen if all the current players in the NFL from Rutgers played on one team, how would they do? Now, I decided to see how that happened by putting them into Madden and doing a season simulation. Now, I have the coach as Greg Schiano, who is the guy who coached many of these players who are now in the NFL. Now, let's see what the roster is. Now, this team's starting quarterback will be 71 overall, Tom Savage. But you'll notice this as his college is Pittsburgh. Well, some people don't know that Tom Savage went to Rutgers but then transferred to Pittsburgh. And there are no quarterbacks right now in the NFL who actually went to Rutgers for their full career. So he'll be the starting quarterback. At starting running back, we have 73 overall Gus Edwards, who is actually a rookie who came out this year undrafted and started for the Ravens late in the season after Alex Collins got injured and actually started playing very well. Now, as our fullback, we have 63 overall Michael Burton. Hasn't been playing that much, but was a pretty good fullback at Rutgers. Now we are at the wide receiver core, which I think is actually the best position for this team, with 82 overall Mohamed Sanu, 77 overall Brandon Coleman, 73 overall Kenny Britt, and 70 overall Leontay Crew. Now, all these guys were very, very good wide receivers at Rutgers, and some, like Sanu and Britt, have had very good success in the NFL. Now, at tight end, we have 79 overall Tyler Croft, who was actually going to play for the Bengals after Tyler Eifert got injured, but ended up also having an injury, which ended his season. Now, there are no current linemen in the NFL that are from Rutgers that are in Madden, so we're skipping to the defensive line, where we have 70 overall George Johnson Jr. at right end. At left end, we have 78 overall Kamoko Touré, who is the highest-rated rookie for Rutgers this year and was picked in the second round by the Colts. At left outside linebacker, we have 67 overall Steve Longa, who in 2015 led the Big Ten in solo tackles. At right outside linebacker, we have 69 overall Jonathan Freeney. Another position that is very good for this team is cornerback, with 87 overall Jason McCourty and 83 overall Logan Ryan. Now, at free safety, we have Rutgers' highest-rated player in Madden, Devin McCourty, who is a 92 overall. At strong safety, we have 79 overall Daron Harmon. Okay, so our Rutgers team went 5-11, which is actually a lot better than I thought we would. So now we are going to check out the stats. Okay, so we finished 30th in offense, which is what I kind of expected, so we must have done very good on defense to get that 5-11 record. And I was correct, our defense did very well, finishing 14th in the NFL. Now we're going to check out the player stats. Okay, so Tom Savage did very good at quarterback, throwing for 3,737 yards with a 62 completion percentage and 27 touchdowns to only 6 picks. Wow. That's actually a lot better than I thought he would do. Gus Edwards had a pretty decent season, going for 866 yards, 3.3 yards per carry, and 6 touchdowns. Now on to the receiving core, where Brandon Coleman led the team with receptions with 94, Sanu in second with 87, Croft with 49, Britt with 45, Edwards with 23, and Carew with 15. Then in yards, Sanu led the team with 1,112, Coleman second with 937, Britt with 552, Croft with 518, Edwards with 253, and Crew with 149. And then with touchdown receptions, Britt led the team with 8, Croft with 5, Coleman with 3, Sanu with 2, Edwards with 2, and Carew with 2. Okay, on defense, our leading tackler was Daron Harmon with 90, second was Logan Ryan with 78, Jason McCourty of 71, a couple other guys who aren't from Rutgers, and then Devin McCourty with 60. Okay, now on to actual tackles. The one before was solo tackles. Daron Harmon at 110, Logan Ryan 91, Jason McCourty 86,
and Devin McCourty, 84. Our leader in interceptions was Logan Ryan with 3, Daron Harmon with 2, Devin McCourty with 2, Jonathan Freeney with 1, and Steve Longo with 1. Now on to our schedule, where we started off 0-4, but then went on a 3-game winning streak, beating the 49ers by 3, the Vikings by 17, and the Broncos by 1. And then week 8, we lose to the 49ers.
In week 10, we lose to the Chiefs. Then in week 11, we beat the Raiders by 3. Then we go on a 5-game losing streak. And then in week 17, we beat the Seahawks by 5.
Thank you, everyone, for watching this video, and I hope you enjoyed it.